Yo, what's going on, guys? Bobby here, and today we are back, and we're back with a bang. Tomorrow is the 15 win challenge, so we're gonna be showing you guys the absolute best comps master's guide to winning this 15 win challenge. With that being said, let's hop into the games and let's show you guys the comps. So going into game one, something that a lot of YouTubers don't talk about when making these 15 win challenge videos or challenge videos itself is the level of competition. Now, in your first game, which is going to be Super Stadium, you're going to be playing a lot of people who aren't really that good. They're not going to be as high level as the people who are on the final map, so you have to run comps accordingly. When you're playing bad players, it's okay to run tanks. In fact, it's preferred. Worse players don't hit as many shots, thus tanks are really, really strong. In an upper trophy meta, you know, range is definitely more prominent, where in lower, tanks are really good. So on the first map, Super Stadium, I would suggest running a Poco double tank, preferably Poco, BB, and a tank, either Jackie or Rosa. All three of these brawlers are very, very common, and if you were to go in solo, I would suggest running BB as your solo if you're going in with randoms. But that being said, let's hop right into the second map. So hopping into the second map, we have Dueling Beetles Hot Zone. Now, Hot Zone is a new addition to competitive this year. Gonna be pretty interesting. I'm not the biggest fan, but I also don't hate it.
Stop the cap.
Now, what we're gonna be running is Penny, Tick, and Sandy. So you're gonna 100% wanna have Penny as your lane. A Penny turret in the corner is so lethal on this map, and only throwers can take it out since it's super hard to get that aggro position on this Hot Zone map. For mid, you're gonna wanna run a thrower, either Tick or Sprout. I prefer Tick, and if you're free to play, you're probably only going to have Tick and not have Sprout. Although Sprout is a really good option, and if you're more comfortable with Sprout and have him, then I would definitely go ahead and run Sprout over Tick. With your other lane, you're going to want to run Sandy. Sandy is really good, and the super is amazing in Hot Zone. Since there's only one zone, you can be really sneaky around that zone and basically take everyone out. Now, if you don't have Sandy and you're free to play, you can be running the other lane that we're going up against, which is Ems, which is really strong since everyone is in one compacted area. You can do a lot of damage, have a lot of control, and I would definitely recommend running the Hype Star Power so that you can gain health over time when people are in your super, not people, I guess, brawlers. But that is going to be this map. Let's move on to the next one and let's keep going. Moving on to the third map, which is going to be Hot Potato. This is where you're going to start facing better competition. You're going to get some teams that are pretty good. So in the first two maps, you want to make sure you really don't drop any of your games. You have to save all of your losses for the last three maps, preferably the last two. So what you want to have here is a Jesse mid. The mid is the most important on this map. So try and have your best player if you're running a team. Grab that mid. Mids that you're going to see commonly here are Jesse, Rico, and 8-Bit. The reason I recommend Jesse is because Jesse, obviously, against Jesse is an even matchup. Jesse can three-shot a Rico, and as long as you're not just running up and dying, it's pretty easy. And then 8-Bit is really strong, but only when you have turret. It's pretty high-skilled, and it's not really necessary to run one, as well as Jesse does a really good job against it. Now, you're going to obviously run Hyper Turret or whatever it is, not Hyper Turret. I don't know what it's called. But the fast turrets, you can get that high DPS. You're going to want to have a Barley lane. Barley is incredibly strong on this map. Would 100% suggest running it. And then you're also going to run a Shield BB. Shield BB is really strong in the meta. I would suggest it for a lot of different comps on a lot of different maps. It is really, really good. But this is definitely, in my opinion, the best comp to run in the 15 win challenge on Hot Potato. Now, coming up next, we have Hard Rock Mine. Now, Hard Rock Mine is a very interesting map. And we're actually going to use two new brawlers with two new gadgets on this map. We're gonna have Rosa and Mr. P. To start off, the Mr. P wants to throw his new gadget right in the middle of the map. What this is gonna do is allow you as a mid to gain control. Why does it do this? Because whatever their mid is, usually gonna be an 8-bit or a Piper, is gonna have to shoot it. Shooting it wastes ammo, also forces it to move back a little bit while you're just shooting at it, so you're gonna have control. It's really, really good to be running that Mr. P and just to use that gadget in the mid to start off. Our other lane is going to be Rosa. Now, Rosa is a new one. Literally today, the new gadget came out, and it is so, so strong. Now, if you don't have the new gadget, it's okay. The old gadget is just as good. You can make a whole jungle on a lane, preferably a lane where they don't have a wall break, and you can kind of just dominate and bush camp their spawn. And then as your mid, you're definitely going to want to run 8-Bit. 8-Bit's just the most powerful. It's really strong against literally everything. If you are very high skilled, you can go with a Piper mid, but I wouldn't suggest it over an 8-Bit at all. And you can even go Nani mid, but again, I wouldn't really suggest it. This is a really powerful comp. It's not too uncommon to have all these brawlers. I'm pretty sure majority of you guys have all these brawlers, so it shouldn't be too bad anyways. But the gadgets are not essential. You don't need the new Rosa gadget. You don't need the new Mr. P gadget. It just helps out. But these are the three brawlers that I would definitely run on Hard Rock Mine. Now for Canal Grande, we're going to show you guys two different maps, since this is where you're going to face your hardest opponents. Everyone here is going to be really good at the game and probably in a team. So I'm going to show you guys two comps, and based off of your team strengths and what you have, you guys can decide what you want to do. For our first comp, we're going to have Tick, Sprout, and Mr. P. Now this is such an annoying comp. I would suggest running the new star or the new gadget, sorry, for Tick, and the new gadget for Mr. P. You're likely going to go up against another Sprout, maybe a Piper, a Mr. P, a Tick, brawlers along those lines who are really, really good here. Now, what this does is it's just an annoying comp. It's really hard to get position away from these guys. Once a Sprout has position, a Tick has position, a Mr. P has position, it is incredibly difficult to get it back. So what I would suggest is just try not to die at the start. Take your time, work as a team, be patient, and once you get that first kill, it's almost a lock that you guys are going to win that game. Now, you guys might not have Sprout, because Sprout obviously is a legendary brawler, and if you don't have Sprout and you want to run some form of combination, I would just go with Gene to help them keep in their spawn, because that pull is super annoying for when they're trying to come out of spawn and you can just pull them away. And this is probably Gene's best map in the meta right now. But on this map, if you guys want to win and have the absolute best comp, Tick and Mr. P do feel like a must. Now onto our second comp, we're going to be going with Piper, Mr. P, and Tick. Now, if you have one thrower, Tick and Sprout are replaceable. Personally, I think Tick is actually better than on this map, and this is the one map that I do think Tick is better. But you can easily run Sprout if you think Sprout is better, or if you're better with Sprout or anything like that, you can definitely run Sprout. You don't need to have Tick. Now, Piper is really strong on this map, although it does get countered by brawlers like Tick, Sprout, Mr. P, etc. So Piper's a little bit more of a risk, but if you feel like you're a sharpshooter and you can hit your shots, I would definitely 100% recommend running Piper. I personally am probably going to run Piper when I do play this map, because I do enjoy Piper and I do think I can hit my shots enough to make it effective, and a really good Piper on this map can completely control the entirety of the game. But with that being said, the other one is easier, it's more reliable, it has less counters, and unless you face a Mortis, the other comp is more likely to win, unless you do have a crazy sharpshooter on your team. Now, just a little strategy for this map, you guys can triple up a lane. What this causes them to do is kind of funnel into you. They have to come to you if you're winning and you're tripling up a lane, so there's no reason why you can't just chill on your lane, all three of you, and just hold them back and have them trying to push to you, but they're not going to be able to do anything. But anyways, that is going to be it for the video. I know I've taken a lot of time off, but it's for a lot of reasons, a lot of it doing with esports and preparing for the esports season that starts up literally tomorrow. But I'm going to be back on that YouTube grind. I'm going to try and go for a video every day, maybe once every 2 days. But that's going to be it for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys learned a ton.